is a personal label, and then it is getting constructed into an app. I have written a few modern poetry in Urdu and also tried to pen some two aspects. One is Shabda and one is Nada. And music is very vast, you know. I think the whole universe is music. I feel music is God. You know what Mukha means? Silence. Out of silence is what music is for. Or regular intervals of silence in it will have its own effect, its own healing effect on the listener. The mood of a musician only will be such that they don't want to listen to any music. They want silence. A signature that we use in creating a composition, the keys that we use in creating a composition, all these things will have its own effect on the listener. But anywhere when silence is part of the composition, that will have the highest effect on the listener. There is no formula for a composition.
Yeah.
Like it is, because it is not that mechanical.
Welcome back to my channel, Digital Wellness. Today, I'm in conversation with a very, very interesting and an eminent guest, Ramya Vasishth. She is an epitome of what is called living the dream. She is multi-talented, very focused, and above all, is a big discoverer. You will see through why I use the phrase discoverer. She is a trained Carnatic Hindustani musician, and she tells me that her passion for music started as young as when she was a 3-year-old kid. Her power of music has seen her working as a music director, a composer, and she is also played a lot of roles in the entertainment industry, especially in the Karnataka industry, also in many languages. She is a big achiever, and when I saw her resume, she had a whole long list of achievements, which, you know, I will leave it in my description below. But one thing which you know was very outstanding was during the centenary celebrations of Kuvempu, she actually received the Tunga Taranga Award. You know, she has got 100% in Karnataka classical vocal music. I know how hard it is, because when I was a young child, I always dreamt to finish my junior and senior exams, and I was very impressive to note that she had 100% marks and she was a first rank holder. You know, the list can go long, 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 but I wanted Ramya to speak and share not only her experiences, and also, very interestingly, there's a lot of connection with digital wellness and the work we do with digital wellness, and my interesting thoughts that I shared with Ramya. So let us get started and let's get to hear from Ramya her thoughts. Ramya, welcome to my channel, Digital Wellness.
Thank you so much, Sujata ma'am. Thanks a lot for having me on your channel, because you have been doing such wonderful job of, you know, having come off the mainstream software job of yours and then doing all this. It takes a lot, you know, to follow one's passion, and you're doing it, you know, and making people believe that age is just a number. So you are you yourself is so inspiring to all of us. Thank you so much for having me.
Ramya. You know, one thing, like I said, you know, your list of achievements go on and on and on. And, you know, I have personally heard you sing, and what a beautiful voice you have. But what caught my personal attention was, you know, the personal label that you have, the Ramya Raga. You know, what is it? I'm curious to know, what is this Ramya Raga?
Yeah, it is still under construction, but it is something I have composed till date about 500 songs. One is, of course, the I don't know if you remember, Guru Raghavendra Vaibhava was a serial on Suvarna TV.
Yes.
So for which I composed about 150 songs of Purandaradasa and Kanakadasa. So likewise, other than that, of 10 major poets in Kannada, they are Jnanapitha awardees. So there's about 80 songs I have composed, and otherwise some random numbers. And then for so many other albums, like for Kolluru Mookambika, and for of course again to Raghavendra Swami and to Hoskote Veeranjaneya Swami. So all these devotional and original numbers come together and make 500 songs. That's when my friend was suggesting that I should have a personal label and then also think of having an app. So this is what it is. Ramya Raga is a personal label, and then it is getting constructed into an app wherein these 500 songs will be uploaded, and then further whatever I keep working on will keep. And also in the name of Salma Taj, I have written a few modern poetry in Urdu, and also tried to pen some ghazals and nagmes and all that. So all that also I've been thinking of uploading it in Ramya Raga. That's what it is.
Well, how inspiring, you know, that you've written so much based on compositions, you know, of, you know, especially the devotional compositions. You know, I'm really waiting to see that, Ramya. You know, you've done so much in music, art. I'll come to the art later because, you know, this interview will never end given the kind of multifaceted talent that you have. You know, first of all, let me ask you, what is music according to you?
See, in Indic knowledge, when we try to understand this universe, in this world is made of only two aspects. One is Shabda and one is Nada. You know, that's why we call Shiva Parvati as Vagartha Viva Samprato Vagartha Pratipate Jagata Pitaravande Parvati Parmeshwaravan. So what is Shabda Nada is that Parvati and Parameshwara. And what the Shabda Nada means is what I try to convey through the Shabda, and the meaning of it becomes Nada. Okay. So I feel music is a beautiful combination of Shabda and Nada, wherein you try to convey a subject, and that subject gets the form of sound, you know. So music is something where you try to, it's a medium which need not have lyrics always. The notations of it only can become Shabda and Nada. And music is very vast, you know. I think the whole universe is music. I feel music is God. That's all.
You very well said it. It's a very abstract question, but let me tell you why I asked you this question. You know, this is so close to what we do at you know, Digital Wellness and DigiNext Health, which is the company that we run. You absolutely said sound is a healer. You know, sound has so much of healing effect. Knowingly, unknowingly, we are consumers of that healing effect, right? You know, why I feel so much for this particular topic really is because we at Digital Wellness are actually working on kind of delivering personalized music based on moods and emotions of an individual, because moods and emotions are not stagnant or constant. You know, like, for example, you can't be happy throughout. If even in a day, you are not happy throughout the day, or you are not sad throughout the day. But like you rightly said, because you have Nada, you have the Shabda sound, which is, you know, so divine and unexplainable a lot of times, has so much of healing effect. And knowingly, unknowingly, you know, we somehow you know, respond to it. And what if you are able to kind of channelize it, and if you are able to deliver personalized music to you know oneself, it's just going to make a lot of difference. So that's exactly what we do at Digital Wellness. And since you really mentioned about, you know, music being God and music, you know, having the Shabda, Nada, and each of this actually creates that space. So what is your point of view, especially on the effect of mood and emotions that music has, Ramya?
I always feel why we consider Mookambika as the mother of music, because you know what Mooka means? Silence. Okay. So out of silence is what music is born, or the sound is born. So silence is supreme. Silence is the mother. So I feel many a times music with irregular, regular intervals of silence in it will have its own effect, its own healing effect on the listener. And I always feel that many a times the mood of a musician only will be such that they don't want to listen to any music. They want silence. That means they are seeking the mother, not the daughter anymore. So I feel it is like, the whole thing is, it's like the coconut shell. Okay. Outside, if you see the nut as so hard, inside, the coconut is really so soft and, so fragile. Such is music and silence. So the combination of sound and silence is very healing. And the time, intervals that we, signature that we use in creating a composition, the keys that we use in creating a composition, all these things will have its own effect on the listener. But anywhere when silence is part of the composition, that will have the highest effect on the listener.
And, make music based on a set pattern or, deliver it in accordance.
Yes. I feel there is no formula for a composition.
Very good. Yeah.
Like it is, because it is not that mechanical.
Right.
It is not done in any workshop. It is not done in any, factory outlet wherein you get 10 pieces of mid-size, 15 pieces of small, and then whatever the rest is XL. No, it doesn't work like that. It's not just music. I think it doesn't work like that in life itself.
Absolutely.
Everything should be custom-made. Everything is tailor-made. That is when it will all suit that individual, whoever is heeding to that.
Right. No, very well said, because there are millions of sounds, millions of things and millions of compositions, but I think having that personalized space and having that personalized what suits you, because what suits you may not suit me.
Yes.
Right.
What I feel is the same composition will have a lot of shades to it.
Okay.
For example, I don't know if you have heard this Kannada song of Bendre.
Yeah.
He has written Ni hinga noda beda nanna tirugi na hanga nodidare nanna.
Correct.
For a long period, a lot of people thought that it's a romantic song. Mm-hmm. A lover telling it to her lover that why are you staring at me? Don't gaze at me like that.
Right.
But it is actually, he had written it when he lost his child.
Wow.
So the dead child was seeming to have been looking at him, and then he couldn't really, look back and at his own child being dead there, lying. So I feel it is very important for a composer to understand in which shade or mood that the composition has to be. At the same time, I think the composer enjoys that liberty of giving different shades to it, depending on the listener's mood, however the listener would want to take. Like for that matter, Kirvani is a raga, mm-hmm. in which you can bring out the best of the pathos songs. At the same time, you can create the best of the romantic song.
Right.
So one has to know the permutation and combinations of those notes to bring the emotion.
Right.
from it.
You know, it's very well said, because you know, it's not that, you know, you can classify, you can't label, like, you know, these are songs which are for happy, these are songs which are for sad. So yes, it is also, you know, depends upon the whole composition and patterns of song making.
Yeah. In fact, in ghazals, I don't know if you have heard ghazals.
Right. I'm an ardent fan of ghazals.
Okay, great then. You know, all the songs are mostly romantic, mostly of viraha.
Yeah, they're sad.
You know, but you listen to any song, you feel like crying.
Yeah.
That is the, you know, overwhelming effect that a ghazal has on one. That is maybe because of shabda, maybe because of nada.
Right.
Or maybe the combination of both. So
yeah, because you do have the timber, you know, the spaces, and like you said, the silence, right? Because you know, from note to note, you know, there are spacings, there are so much of technical things that go in making a particular music composition. So you very well said that you can't have a one size fits all, you can't use the same brush.
Yeah.
You know, for using the same music. That's very good. You know, coming to your other you know, areas, because you're so multi-talented. You do Urdu poetry, like I said. You know, when I was looking at your profile, I did see your nice message on the Mother's Day probably 2 years back.
Yeah.
That popped up, and it was such a wonderful of course, Urdu poetries are always very overwhelming and very heartwarming. So it was very nice to see. You know, how do you, first of all, switch from, you know, in your spaces, Ramya?
I feel it is just that one energy that God has blessed everybody with.
Mm-hmm.
The manifestation of that energy into various things. That is what it is. I mean, an artist is an artist who can sing, who can paint, who can dance, who can act, who can write. Because it is just that one energy of to be an artist. You know, Ramana Maharshi so beautifully says, being is bigger than doing. So what happens is, if an artist just be, it will happen. It will just manifest into everything else. You know? And everything is interdisciplinary, I feel. It is not that one has to really have a proper training in painting, proper training in dance. I mean, it is the same shastra, it is the same thing one has to, you know. It is just here that how one perceives and how one produces it.
Art is a fabric, right? So whether it's music, whether it's dance, whether it is acting, you know, they all will follow the same fabric. How do you say? So given that, because where I was coming to is, because, you know, we are, you know, using music being therapeutic, or using it for therapy. How can you then use art, you know, for therapeutic means?
See, first of all, the problem with all the art forms, performing art forms, is that we have what do I tell you? You know, that's a beautiful word in Hindi, badnam. We have made them badnam by calling it only for performance. Actually, it is for oneself to just emote, or oneself to just bring it out. It is not really for only the rasika to enjoy it. It is for the you know, container, the one who is actually having it, for them to enjoy. In, you know, in Hindi, in a very desi Hindi, in khadi boli they say gavaya.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
You know, that gavaya is a singer who wants to sing for himself, not that somebody is listening to. I mean, of course, when he takes the herd of, sheep or somewhere, he would want to sing for his own joy. He will not have audience. He will not, and not even those sheep will be listening to him. I don't know, they might be, but he will obviously not be thinking that whether am I making an impact, whether am I considered a good artist. No. You know, this, the first of all, I feel the one who is, thinking of maybe to sing, dance or whatever, they should always see how enjoying it is for their own self. Everything is actually for the self. Then comes the other. You know? So if my Atma is not happy with what I'm doing, then however good that music that you try to play for me, it will obviously not have any effect. In fact, I keep telling a lot of people that they want to listen to music. I keep telling, why don't you sing? Why don't you write? That is a much more therapeutic than listening to somebody, than reading someone. Because what happens is, there is a churning inside that happens when you start writing, when you start singing. When it can be Besura, who is bothered? World in many ways is shaking by coronavirus, not because you are singing Besura, you know. So I feel it's so important for us to make at least the coming generation understand the real purpose of these arts. Not to impress upon anybody, but for the self. It is for the self.
You know, I think you summarized it, that it's all about communication.
Yes, it is communication, but it is to communicate with the self.
Right, I know. Yeah. It's a 360 degree communication.
Yes.
Self, communicating with others.
Others?
Yeah. You can't.
But once you communicate with yourself in the right fashion, or the right communication happens with the self.
Right.
The same best communication happens with the outside world.
For this wonderful, short notice discussion.
And I'm sorry, my mom keeps scolding me all the time that when somebody asks you a question, why do you keep talking philosophy? But I don't know the other way of answering it.
No,
I'm very sorry. I have spoken a lot of philosophy in this whole.
In fact, this philosophy connects very well with the philosophy that we are running here at DigiNext Health and Digital Wellness, because our philosophy is all about delivering personalized music based on moods and emotions to users using technology, because we've been hardcore technologies for many decades now. So
yeah.
we only know technology. So we are trying to deliver personalized music, and you kind of validated that philosophy.
It's just a request to you also, in your app, if you can bring up a particular section wherein, if I want to cry,
yeah,
if I want to laugh, mm-hmm, or if I want to sing, if I want to do anything, if that sound can be captured and analyzed and played back to the same person, will give them a great understanding of the pain or the happiness or whatever that they were going through. It will help them, understand themselves better,
right,
and also help them relieve those, confusion.
She mentioned about, like I said, the story of the coconut, not the story, you actually, told us about, related it rather to the, coconut, and I think that was very nice. And you also spoke about a single fabric. Art is a single fabric. Doesn't matter, yeah, whether it's music, whether it is different forms, but once you have an ability to do in one, it is always easier for you to kind of shoot. And you are a great example. I can very strongly validate why you are a discoverer. It's very nice.
Very, really very big terms.
I saw the fluency with which you actually delivered that Urdu poetry, and it was amazing to see that, Ramya. Thank you so much, and I'm sure
thank you so much for having me on your show, and you are doing a great job. I'm always with you in this.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.